you have an emotion called pain because the situation is not pleasant, but you are drawing your energy not from pain, from the power of your commitment to contribute that situation in life. When that happened, your kripaya is going to bless you. But what happened to Arjuna? Kripaya vishtam. He was overpowered by kripaya. And when he is overpowered by kripaya, what happens to him? To him there, ashru purna kulekshanam vishidantam. He gets despondent, rejected. And therefore, once when a despondent energy fills you, your wisdom is going to get knocked off. And therefore, you will be dragged. That Arjuna, please see, to that Arjuna, Madhusudana uvacha. Madhusudana means Lord Krishna tells Arjuna. Now, what you have to understand now is in life is also, please see. In life, it is not that you should not have pain. It is not that you should not have difficulty. Don't allow a situation to overpower you.
Hari Om. We'll be starting a series of talks on the second chapter of the Gita. So if you have your Gita book, you can open it and be ready. In the second chapter, if you don't have, just listen. The whole vision of the Gita is to transform an individual from an unconscious living to a conscious living. Because of our unconscious patterns, and we ourselves are not aware we are unconscious, and therefore it is called unconscious. Hence, because of this unconsciousness, humanity is suffering, and we always feel our suffering is because of the situations in life. Very few of us realize that we are suffering not because of the situations in life. We are suffering more because of our unconscious of our life, the unconsciousness not giving you the intelligence to relate to the situation wisely and not otherwise. And that was the whole position of Lord of Arjuna. Arjuna called Parantapa, Dhananjaya, Gudakesha, when he had to face a certain situation, what happened to Arjuna? Sidhanti mama gatrani mukhamcha parishishati. You find there's a breakdown in Arjuna. Now the breakdown in Arjuna fighting the situation, not that he has not faced such situations in life. Now you may feel because of that situation I am suffering is what Arjuna is going to unfold throughout. Because katham bhishmaham sanke dronam cha madhusudana. How do you expect me to fight against Bhishma, against Drona? And they are my gurus. All this he says this. And therefore, because of my unique position, I am miserable. But the Lord is going to unfold. It is not because of the situation you are miserable. It is because of your unconscious, which is not bringing you the appropriate intelligence to deal with the situation, that a person is miserable. If there is an electrical equipment and you put your finger and get a shock, right, the shock comes more, you do not know how to handle that electrical equipment appropriately. And since you do not know, you put a finger at a wrong place and thus get a shock there. And therefore, humanity's suffering is because of our unconscious. And to become conscious of the unconscious is the very vision of wise living. Since we are unconscious, therefore, we are not aware it is unconscious. If you are aware it is unconscious, then it is not unconscious because you are conscious that you are unconscious. So the guru's task is make you realize there are certain areas in your life where you are conscious. There are certain areas of life where you are unconscious. And the unconscious patterns within our life goes on creating prisons, prisons, prisons and prisons. And therefore, you feel imprisoned more because of our unconscious pattern. And therefore, if you have unconscious, now it goes on creating prison. Even your body can become a prison. this body is such a wonderful, beautiful body, but the body can become a prison if you don't relate to this body wisely. If you relate to this body, all right, this is the best body I've got, konyosti sadrishomaya, and very arrogantly you start relating towards the body, and then you find so many people, a small pimple on the cheeks will make them extremely miserable. A gray hair on their head will make them feel very depressed. So this gray hair is beautiful, pimple is nothing wrong about it, but then this wonderful body, if you relate unconsciously, you convert this body itself into a prison. So too also, mind is extremely beautiful, mind is tremendously wonderful. It tells you, if I have to talk, I have to use my mind. If you understand what I'm to say, you have to use your mind. So mind is such a wonderful instrument God has given us. But if you are relating to your mind very unconsciously, you will find your mind becomes reactive, and the biggest tension we go through in life is because of our mind, or not because of the mind, the unconscious relating to the mind very stupidly, very unintelligently. So the mind also becomes a prison. Feelings are extremely beautiful. Feelings are extremely wonderful. Because we have feelings, the world is so beautiful. A person dead who has no feelings, a person who has life who has feelings, it's so beautiful, right? But now if the feelings are also unconsciously related, then he'll say, Swamiji, I fell in love, what to do? Now I told him, who told you to fall in love? You have to rise in love. And this fellow falls in love instead of rising in love. So feeling also becomes a prison. So the body is wonderful, becomes a prison. Feelings are wonderful, it becomes a prison. Mind is wonderful, it becomes a prison. And therefore we get entrapped by the body, entrapped by the mind, entrapped by the feelings. And we feel the body has entrapped me, the feelings have entrapped me, my mind has entrapped me. But now it is not the body, it is not the mind, it is not the feelings. It is your unconsciously, very unawarefully, very unintelligently, very ignorantly, you are relating towards them. And therefore, you become a slave when you bring the unconscious pattern. So let this sink very deeply. Hence even Lord Shiva says, Chaitanya Atma. The purpose of living is to increase our chaitanya, increase our awareness. When you increase our awareness, even kaupina vantaha kalu bhagyavantaha. Adi Shankaracharya says, even a simple underwear also, kalu bhagyavantaha you become. And therefore this unconsciousness has given vishada. And therefore the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita is vishada. Vishada means sorrow, breakdown in Arjuna, and therefore Krishna converts this vishada into a yoga. Right, means how can you convert your vishada, sorrow, into a yoga? Yoga means yuj, to join. How you can join to higher levels of understanding, where your worry becomes wisdom, your frustration becomes fascination, right? And therefore how to transform is the whole vision of the Bhagavad Gita. But please recognize, as you listen to the Gita, don't listen more to understand the sloka. Let each sloka of the Gita become a darpana, mirror, in which you start seeing your unconscious patterns, which goes on creating prison. The world is extremely wonderful, saundarya lehari, but still few people feel miserable. Miserable about this. It seems once, you know, the Lord came down. He came down and he wanted to see how his whole creation is, and he recognized the person there. Hey, do you remember, right, you were blind and I gave you eyes? The Lord told this blind man, do you remember I blessed you, you were blind, you got eyes? And that man says, the kind of curse you have given me, I can never forget you, O Lord. The Lord was shocked. Giving eyes to a blind person is a wisdom, is a gift or a curse? Is what? It's a gift. And this blind man is telling the Lord, who had come in the form of a guru, he says, you have cursed me with eyesight. The Lord was shocked. How can I curse you with the eyesight? He says, before I was blind, I didn't have any problems. Having given me eyes, I am full of problems, he says. Now the Lord started listening to the Upadeshana. And what is the problem? Because you gave me eyes, now I am able to see beautiful woman. And I am after woman now. When I am after woman, they reject me, I become miserable. I go to another woman, now they reject me, I feel miserable. Before, when I was blind, I could not see the difference between ugly and beautiful. Having given me the eyesight, now I know what is beautiful and ugly, and I am after beautiful people, and then they reject me, I feel miserable. Ah, these eyes you have given me has created so much of mess, so much of mess, so much of mess. What an adbhuta, no? Some of you are listening with no adbhuta at all, because our life story it is. The Lord says, very interesting upadesha this man is giving. So as the Lord was going, then he found a person in the gutter. And he said, hey, why are you in the gutter? And the man looks at him. He said, right? And the Lord said, do you recognize me? Yes, I recognize you. You have cursed my life, he says. The Lord was shocked. How? Are you were lame and I gave you legs. You couldn't walk, I gave you legs. He says, that is the trouble, he says. When I was lame, I was simply sitting in one place. Having given me legs now, now I'm running here, running there, running here. And if I'm not running, I land up in a bar. And when I land up in a bar, I get drunk. When I get drunk, now you see I fall in the gutter. So who is responsible? You. When I didn't have legs, I had very less options in life. Now having given me legs, full of options. And therefore, you have cursed me. You see, a blessing becomes a curse. Even a blessing becomes a curse to an unconscious person. Then the Lord says this is a dangerous place to go now. Because not very encouraging now. Even the blessing is cursed. Right in this place, he says, let me leave this town. And as he is going, he saw a person hanging. He saw a person hanging. So he rushes to him. I say, why are you hanging? And that person says, my God, even now you are not leaving me. And the Lord said, have you forgotten? You were dead, I made you alive. The Lord is in the guru, in the form of a guru there. He said, you were dead and by my ashirwad you became alive. He says, when I am dead, I had no problems at all. Now, having given me life now, please see, when I go home, my wife says a bhuta has come. My boss says a preta has come. Because they saw me dead. Now, after giving me life, I go and tell my wife, now I am alive. He says, no, some bhuta must be there, some preta. Everybody is treating me like a bhuta and preta. When I was dead, I didn't have that problem at all. Having given me life, you have made my life miserable. And now just see, friends, reflect on the story. A blessing has become a curse. A blessing also has become a curse. In life, if you closely see, we are blessed beautifully, but we treat it as a curse, not because of what we have, because of our unconscious with relating to what we have. This unconscious is creating samsara. And the Lord, out of his ashirvad, out of his jnana, out of his bhakti, is trying to transform this unconscious into a conscious. And when your unconscious becomes conscious, your vishada becomes yoga, your sorrow becomes yoga. And therefore, understand deeply, humanity is suffering not because of life. You know, you say always, history goes on repeating, right? History is not going on repeating. Our unconscious goes on repeating, 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 repeating. So one war after another war, after another war, after another war. It is this unconscious which goes on repeating. History does not go on repeating. And therefore, a great message of the Bhagavad Gita is this. If you are unconscious, right, you suffer. Unconscious creates its own prisons. If you are more conscious, more aware, then a difficulty becomes an opportunity to growth. You will convert now samsara into nirvana. But if you are unconscious, you will convert even nirvana into samsara. And therefore, the greatest responsibility is to transform your unconscious into conscious. Arjuna, there is a breakdown. Arjuna feels is because of the situation there is a breakdown. And Krishna says, Lord says, it is not because of the situation there is a breakdown. It is because of your unconscious there is a breakdown. You become more conscious, then you find these situations becomes a great opportunity for you to empower. These situations become a great opportunity for you to contribute. These situations becomes a great opportunity for you to learn. And when you start learning from them, then you will know why there is so much of chaos in spite of being in this wonderful cosmos. And therefore, this is the whole Upadesha of the Bhagavad Gita. And when this is the Upadesha, now in our lives also we see the Jivatma in us will say, I am miserable because of this, this, this. And if your Paramatma in you says, hey, you are miserable because of your unawareness, unawareness, unawareness. Can we therefore baptize this unawareness into awareness? And therefore the great book of wisdom, the Bhagavad Gita, filled with the deepest of message. But the Gita has to be listened with lot of bhakti. Use your head and your heart. Only your heart is not enough. Only your head is not enough. Your head and heart. And then you will find the verses are not words. You find the verses are divine vibrations. Right, the verses create such deep understanding. They bring about a tremendous jagran, a tremendous wakefulness in you. And in the light of that wakefulness, life gains a different luster, a different beauty, and this whole world becomes a saundarya lehari. So it is this wakefulness which we have to really focus. So let every verse be a spiritual stimulant in which I start looking at my unconscious ways of our living. And when you start doing this, you find, please see, our life becomes a tremendous pilgrimage from the now to the now to the now there. With this, if you have the Gita book with you, right? Keep the second chapter of the Gita called Sankhya Yoga, and then verse to verse that we will start unfolding the verses. I'll try to less desanskritize so you'll understand, but I'll unfold it there, okay? The first verse.
Sanjaya Uvacha Tam Tatha Kripaya Vishtam Ashru Purna Kule Chanam Vishidhantam Idham Vakyam Uva Madhusudana Uvacha Madhusudana Tam Tatha Kripaya Vishtam Ashru Purna Kule Vishidhantam Idham Vakyam Uvacha Madhusudana Uvacha Madhusudana.
Tatha Kripaya Vishtam अश्रुपूर्णाकुलेक्षणम विशीदंतम इदं वाक्यम उवाच मधुसूदन. द होल भगवद गीता इज द साइकोलॉजी ऑफ हाउ अ मिजरेबल माइंड वर्क्स and also the Bhagavad Gita is the wisdom how to come out of this miserable psychology. It is just not the psychology, it is talking something which is beyond the psychology. Psychology talks about understanding the mind. Maximum it talks about how to transform the mind. But psychology does not talk about the transcendence of the mind. To understand the mind is one level. To transform the mind is yet another level. To go to transcend the mind is yet another level. And unless the transcendence of the mind doesn't happen, we will continue being in a very colorful, miserable, comfortable, miserable state. How to bring about this transcendence? Is what is very important in the whole psychology of the Gita. And hence please see, now Sanjaya says this. Sanjaya is explaining everything to Dhritarashtra, and Sanjaya is saying, tam tatha kripaya vishtam ashru purna kulekshanam vishidantam idam vakyam uvacha Madhusudana. Feel those verses. He says, hey, Arjuna's plight is what? He tells Sanjaya, tells Dhritarashtra, Arjuna's plight is what? Tam tata kripaya vishtam. Kripaya vishtam ashru purna kulekshanam. Arjuna's eyes were filled with tears. Why? Because kripaya vishtam. It's not that Arjuna just wanted to kill his brothers and go ahead. He was stricken by Kripaya, and since he was stricken by this emotion of sympathy, his eyes were filled with tears. Tam tata Kripaya vishtam ashru purna kulekshanam. His eyes were filled. Vishidantam idam vakyam. This sorrow-stricken Arjuna, uvacha Madhusudana. Lord Krishna, the Madhusudana, and uses the right word Madhusudana for Lord Krishna because he killed a great Rakshasa called Madhu. Right? A great Rakshasa called Madhu, and the greatest Rakshasa in you and I is our unconscious. The greatest Rakshasa within you and I is our Ahankar. And when Lord Krishna could kill that great Rakshasa Madhu, why can't he kill the Rakshasa in the unconscious Bhaktas of you and I? How can't he kill this there? And therefore, but what is the state? He gives a clear picture. He is Kripaya Vishtam. Right? Please see, there's a difference between sympathy and empathy. Please understand, there's a like to empathize somebody is beautiful. Right? But if you have, please see, sympathy is a different thing. Kripa is very, very different from Daya. What happened to Arjuna? Please see, when you have sympathy with somebody, your center gets anchored in the other. Your center gets anchored in the other and you will be pulled by the other. Whereas, when you empathize somebody, when somebody comes with sorrow, somebody comes with tension, you empathize that person. When you empathize, you feel his sorrow, but you are anchored in your wisdom.